see you. 2 minutes.
Thank you.
sure you know what you want.
Thank you.
Your Majesty, Your Royal Highnesses, Members of the Senedd and Special Guests.
Members of the Senedd and Special Guests.
Welcome to you all. Today marks the official opening of our 6th Senedd.
Passing of the Senedd and Elections Act of 2020, we are today opening the first full term of Senedd Cymru, the Welsh Parliament. As a result also of that act, our members here today were elected for the first time by an electorate that included the 16 and 17-year-olds of Wales. At May's election, we elected our first woman of colour to this Parliament, Natasha Ashgar. But we have more to do to deepen our democracy and broaden our diversity, and we will seek to do so during this Senedd term.
We here are a reflection of the diversity of the people of Wales, but there is still more to do to increase the diversity of our Senedd and to further embed our democracy. And we will work to do just that during this Senedd term.
Like all parliaments around the world, our work over the past 18 months has been dominated in both practice and content by the coronavirus pandemic as we sought to keep our country as safe as possible. We thank all the people of Wales, our health and care workers in particular, for their extraordinary efforts during this time.
We are greatly indebted to those who worked so exceptionally hard during the pandemic, especially our health and care staff, who went above and beyond for all of our sakes.
Today we are joined by COVID champions from all parts of Wales who worked in very many different ways to support others and tackle coronavirus in their communities. Croeso I chi gyd. As the Llywydd, one of my most uplifting days in this chamber was chairing the very first meeting of our Senedd ieuenctid, the Welsh Youth Parliament. Elected for the first time in 2018, the young parliamentarians provided a new dynamic to our work here. And we are joined by their representatives today. We are also joined by some of Wales's newest residents, a young family who fled the streets of Kabul recently and found a safe home for themselves, along with others, here in our nation of sanctuary.
Welcome, therefore, to representatives of your Youth Parliament today, and thank you for your work. And we look forward to working with your successors in the new Youth Parliament that is about to be elected. Welcome to the asylum seekers from Afghanistan, to their national parliament, their Senedd, on the day it is officially opened.
We continue to work through the pandemic in scrutinising government and passing legislation. We were one of the first parliaments in the world to meet virtually and to vote remotely. Even in the depths of lockdown, democracy continued in Wales. Our work as a Senedd for the next term will undoubtedly focus on recovering from the COVID pandemic. But there will also be many other challenges and opportunities, from playing a leading role in tackling climate change to promoting equality and fairness for all in Wales.
Let our 6th Senedd be productive and innovative, and let us respect at all times each other as members and all the people we represent.
6th Senedd, let it be productive and innovative. And let us respect at all times each other as members and all the people we represent. I ask you now, Your Majesty, to address the Senedd.
Llywydd, First Minister and members of the Senedd, it is a pleasure to be with you today, and I congratulate you on your recent election. You have been entrusted to be the voice of the people of Wales, to represent their interests when decisions that affect their everyday lives are debated and decided within these walls. When I was here for the last opening in 2016, I noted that the Fifth Assembly would mark a significant development in the history of devolution in Wales. Since then, further measures have been taken to strengthen the foundations of your parliamentary democracy. The Wales Act 2017 established this parliament on a new basis, and you've used this legislation to help the public better understand your work and to include more people in the democratic process. As a result, This Parliament is now recognised in law as Senedd Cymru, or the Welsh Parliament. The name reflects this institution's evolution over its 22 years into one with lawmaking powers over a wide range of areas that are central to Welsh life and the ability to vary taxes. It demonstrates your status as a national parliament working on behalf of the people of Wales. You are also reaching out to every generation, and the establishment of the first Welsh Youth Parliament has provided another opportunity for the voices of young people to be heard, enabling them to make a valuable contribution to the Senedd's work. You are also to be commended for your innovation. This was the first of the United Kingdom's legislatures to hold a formal virtual meeting. The fact that all parties showed a determination that you should continue to meet is commendable and testament to your commitment to scrutinise the government on behalf of the people of Wales. I have spoken before about how recent times have, in many ways, brought us closer together. We all owe a debt of gratitude to those who have risen so magnificently to the challenges of the last 18 months, from key workers to volunteers who have done so much to serve their communities. They are shining examples of the spirit for which the Welsh people are so renowned, a spirit which I have personally encountered so many times. It is a source of pleasure that both the Prince of Wales and the Duchess of Cornwall, together with the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge, have had homes in Wales and experienced its very special sense of community. The Welsh people have much to be proud of, and over the next 5 years, I am sure you will continue to be inspired by their indomitable spirit, as you represent the interests of Wales and its people, makes laws for Wales, and holds the Welsh Government to account. There are many challenges ahead as you work together to promote the well-being of the people of Wales and support the recovery effort. The Prince of Wales, the Duchess of Cornwall, and I extend our warmest good wishes to you for the sixth session of this Parliament and hope you have every success with your endeavours. Diolch o galon. Thank you.
As First Minister, may I begin by saying that it is a pleasure to welcome you, Your Majesty, to the Senedd today as you open the sixth Senedd session. Thank you for your kind words. May I thank you for the support that you have shown our Senedd since you opened our first session in 1999. And also thank you for your service to the country over the years.
The opening of this sixth Senedd session is a time for all of us to look to the future. People from all corners of Wales, including those most distant from this building, have chosen 60 members to represent our collective ambitions and to steer a course for our country. In the years ahead, I'm sure that we will argue and disagree about what is best for Wales, but always in this Senedd term, with the interests of those we represent at the centre of everything that we do. Now, we gather for this sixth Senedd in the shadow of the coronavirus pandemic, a pandemic which has created so much sorrow for so many families across Wales. And we pause, as we do regularly in this chamber, to think of each one of them today. At the same time, we've seen the very best of Wales in our health and care system, the shop workers, the teachers, all those public service workers, the businesses and volunteers whose commitment, dedication and sheer hard work has helped to keep Wales open during this most difficult of times. As we look beyond the pandemic, we recognise that we still have many challenges ahead. To meet them, we will use all of our powers to promote prosperity, equality and well-being for everyone in Wales, and to turn ourselves to that other great crisis of our times, the crisis in climate change and the loss of our biodiversity. As elected representatives, we have the privilege and the duty to defend and to strengthen our democracy, to promote the well-being of all of our citizens, and to promote the natural beauty of the country in which we are so lucky to live, here in Wales. And uniquely, to do so with our self-imposed obligations to take into account the needs of future generations in everything as a government and as a Senedd we decide here in this chamber.
My genim ni sawl enw.
We have several names.
Crewr Gromlech.
The Ponty Panthers.
Dawnswyr Afon Dyfi.
The Gwent Giants.
Mellt Main Clollog.
And the Cardiff Mixing Pot.
Y Brain Bendigedig Betws Gwerfyl Goch.
We are the musty smell of rooms, of damp wood and rotting leaves.
Ni yw'r crir goelanod a chyffro'r wal goch.
We are in teulu mawr.
Ac ni yw sŵn y tractors yn sio fel gwenwyn yn y ceau gwaith.
Wildlife, pond life.
Ni yw'r adeiladau newydd ar pocedi gweigion.
Mossy, slimy rocks and information boards.
Ni yw rai sy'n hapus ac yn drist.
We are made of iron, of meandering rivers.
Ac ni yw waliau, Senedd Glyndŵr.
Foxes, badgers, owls and woodpeckers.
Ac ni yw'r Gymraeg sy'n ein glido at ein gilydd fel mêl gwyllt.
We are the tasty, scrumptious, crumbly Welsh cakes.
Ni yw'r cychod sy'n ein cario i'r ynysoedd nesaf.
We are vast readers, weird singers and friendly dancers.
Dyw'r cerig man a'r creigiau moel.
And we pride ourselves on kindness and we know what it is to feel hiraeth.
Ac rydyn ni'n gwybod fod na bobl yng Nghymru yn llygu.
And we know what it's like to have mixed emotions.
Fod capeli yn arogli fel hen llyfrau. A dillad neiniau a fferins a gweddiau.
When I speak Welsh, I can taste my tongue.
Bod hiliaeth yn stain ar y galon.
Our mountains stand ragged and rocky.
Fod Cymreicdod yn brofiad sir felys fel blas mwyar dion ar dafod.
We speak Arabic, Tamil, Urdu and Afrikaans.
Ac mae bara brith yw'r bara'r nefoedd. A mi fod o'n oroglu'n dawyll ac yn dynar fel ti, mam gi.
Welsh, English, Turkish, Telugu and Somali.
A bod yn am y ddawn i fod yn genedl. A'r cyfan rydyn ni eisiau.
And all we want.
Yw bod yn ffrind i wledydd eraill.
To keep the air clean so we can breathe.
Allai o dywod rhwng ein brachdanau.
A trampoline in the chimney so we can reach the clouds.
A bod neb yn trasio parciau plant y fori.
For our girls to have the same opportunities as our boys.
Ac rydyn ni'n mynd. Yr hawl i cael byw yn ein cymunedau.
Robot butlers and the Welsh flag on the moon.
Rydyn eisiau gwyrddni ac awyr iach ac arogl dom.
Our unique voices were made to be heard.
Rydyn ni'n moyn cymryd pleser yn ein gwaith. Yn gymwys fel y gwna mam gi, wrth iddo weithio tarden rhywbob.
We want to set an example for the rest of the world.
Thank you. I was a farmer before, so I'm a deer farmer. Mm. Yes, so we farm deer up in the Bracken Beacons. Yes. It's going very well at the moment, actually. We're just coming out of the rut, so yes. It's
good. I am indeed, yes. Before I used to work on the NHS for 11 years, I worked in physiotherapy, mental health, and learning disabilities. Bit of a change, shall we say?
I was working in education as a teaching assistant for a while. Just a lot of similarities.
And now we go on.
This is Alan Davis.
No.
I sit next to him in committee.
This is leading me astray as a new member as well. Yeah,
so we have some. Have you been able to come here?
Yeah. Well, I can get here on my bicycle because I represent one of the Cardiff seats.
Really important for us in terms of access and in terms of childcare, so it's really important.
I mean, Zoom's more or less all right, isn't it? It's slightly disadvantaged.
It has a limitation. Used it a number of times.
Thank you.
Well, that's not the case. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I don't think so.